It's no secret that the he351ve and he300vg are turbochargers ripe for upgrade. If you're a 2007.5 to 2018 Cummins owner, you've probably been shopping for one, or maybe you've bought one already. These trucks thrive on air. Whether you're towing, whether you're an enthusiast looking for more airflow for performance, maybe you're just looking to cool the truck down. Whatever you're looking to do, we've engineered the Stealth 64 to deliver. The reality is the factory turbochargers in these trucks perform really well at that 350 horsepower mark. They're quick spooling units, they get up there and they perform and they do their job. But when you try and push them beyond 340 horsepower, 350 horsepower, when you try and run 400 plus horsepower, especially for a long time at a clip, like maybe if you're towing or in a performance application, the heat generated by those situations is gonna quickly shorten the life cycle of these turbochargers. And that's why we see a lot of failures in the aftermarket. When engineering our version of the Stealth 64 for this turbocharger, our goal was to let this thing breathe, get more airflow through it, lower the drive pressure, and really allow the turbine side to do its job all the way out to that 500-600 horsepower range and above. Over my years in tuning, I've had the opportunity to run just about everybody else's offering for an aftermarket turbocharger on these trucks. And what I found is that you have to work this factory vane cage so hard in those units to get the extra power that oftentimes it's counterproductive. It just seemed like nobody was addressing the root of the problem, which is the turbine side. It's just not big enough. The turbine's the engine of the turbocharger. It's connected to the compressor wheel, and it basically determines the potential horsepower that can be driven by the compressor. Now, we need horsepower to compress air to get it into the motor. The more turbine horsepower we can make, the more airflow we can generate. Let me show you what I mean. On the factory turbine on these trucks, you have an inducer that's very narrow. When you have that very narrow inducer, you're forced to use a lot of pressure in order to get horsepower out of this turbine. What we want to do is not only use a bigger turbine, but also allow our vanes, which are the forces acting on and directing gas over those turbines, to affect a larger area. We've focused our engineering and testing efforts over the past couple years on building a turbine that was going to generate horsepower that we needed to make power and also offer great spool up. How'd we do it? Well, we built our turbine to have a wider inducer. So we grew the inducer. On top of that, we built our own custom nozzle ring. And this nozzle ring allows the vanes to affect the nozzle area to match that growth. Then we machined all the parts inside the turbine assembly to make these two work the way they should. What does that get us? Well, it gets us more engine, gets us more horsepower, and we can use that horsepower to move more air through the compressor side. Up to 30% more airflow through the compressor side. That translates into usable horsepower in your truck. You guys at home might be thinking, okay, custom exhaust pieces, custom nozzle, custom shroud plate, what does that mean for my turbine braking? Well, turbine braking stays as good as it is in OEM format, so you don't lose any horsepower in turbine braking. That's awesome if you're considering keeping a VGT because you like towing. Furthermore, spool up matches OEM. Okay, so one of the critical elements in the design of this turbine was to maintain factory spool up. We absolutely do not want to sacrifice the transient response or the throttle response as you lean into the throttle on these trucks. The VGT turbochargers are notorious for having great throttle response. We want to keep that. And last but not least, as a tuner, I want to make this turbocharger easy to tune. I don't want to have you go through 3 or 4 revisions with your tuner to get this thing right. My goal was to make it perform well on a tune that would work on a factory stock truck. So that means that you're not gonna have to go to your tuner and say, oh, I got this newfangled turbocharger and you gotta change all these tables and you gotta work on it for 3 hours and send me a bunch of revisions. No, put this turbocharger on and go. Can it be run on a stock file, 100% stock truck? Absolutely. Okay, so I've walked you through the turbine side. I've showed you how we made that extra horsepower to drive the compressor to move more airflow through the engine. We also modified the compressor wheel. So the factory compressor wheel has been upsized to our 64 millimeter 11 blade setup. Great compressor wheel for making 700 plus horsepower. The 11 blade setup offers a very wide operating efficiency range. You guys who have run aftermarket turbochargers in the past may be familiar with surge. Surge is a common problem on larger turbocharger trucks that are tried to use or guys try to tow with them. This turbocharger does not have that issue. Our 11 blade setup has a nice wide map and it mitigates surge. So you can lean on the truck at low RPM where these engines are designed to work, and you don't have to worry about the turbocharger coughing, sputtering, beating the bearings up, doing stuff it shouldn't. We know reliability and durability is a top priority for you. Our goal with this turbocharger is to get you a quick responding, high airflow turbocharger is going to keep your truck cool, keep drive pressures totally manageable, give you great response, and have a product that's going to last over the long-term life of your truck. If you want to know more, check this product out on DuramaxTuner.com or give us a call at 815-568-7920. We'd be happy to talk to you about how this turbocharger can work on your vehicle. I'm Nick Prignitz. Thanks for watching.